Good morning, students. I am back again with your history, Standard 7, Part 2, Chapter 1, Rise of Christianity, the Continuation. As explained to you earlier, children, what do we mean by rise of Christianity? It is how Christianity spread. Who started Christianity? I have discussed in our previous class. So now we will proceed with the further topics. In the first slide, children will see how Jesus Christ taught people, his teachings. So previously, what do you mean by the sermon? Sermon here means a talk on a religious or moral subject. So Jesus talked by sitting on the mount, that same topic, that religious topic or moral subject which he was having to talk with people. His most famous sermon was that which was delivered by whom? It was delivered by Jesus, in which he talked with his people. And I'll show you the picture in the next slide. We have learnt about the preachings. Now we are going to learn about the teachings. Number one, Jesus was a great healer. Jesus healed people. He used to restore the sight of the blind. He used to heal the sick. By just his healing power, people used to become all right. So in second point, we see his simple lifestyle. He never lived a life full of luxury or any comforts. So his life was quite simple. He used to love and actually his lifestyle was also love and compassion he had for people earned just because of his simple lifestyle and the love and compassion he had for people, that is empathy or sympathy you can say, he had for the mercy which he had for people. Just because of that, people used to love him. And like this only, he earned many followers. So lots of followers were there. So here you can see compassion he had for people earned him a lot of followers. This is how he earned a lot of followers. How? By his simple lifestyle, his love and compassion which he used to show to other people. So that earned him followers. In number third point, we see he rejected meaningless rituals. The rituals which were without meaning, without any cause, people were continuously following it. Or blind, you can say, a blind thought or a blind thinking which we do. So without any seeing, we just trust anything and we start following that particular thing. So he condemned it. He actually wanted to abolish all those things. Jesus scolded people to follow that hypocrisy and greed. Hypocrisy is actually the contrivance of a false appearance of virtue. Like you are not so good, but you are trying to show your character. You are concealing your real character. You are hiding your real character and you are showing the false appearance. So he hated that. He scolded people not to follow hypocrisy and greed. We should not be greedy. Okay, now next point, the number fourth point, that is the Sermon on the Mount is the most famous sermon delivered by Jesus. In this slide, children, we can see a picture where Jesus is sitting on a mount, where it is said the Sermon on Mount. Here only he sat and gave a sermon that was the most famous sermon which was delivered by Jesus. And what did he say in that sermon? As I talked with you earlier and I explained you that a sermon is a talk on a religious subject or a moral subject. So here also he is talking something regarding the religious or moral subject. He is saying, number one, love your enemies. Now we should never hate our enemies. If you hate your enemy, they'll again hate you. So in return, love You cannot expect from them. But if you love your enemy, even though they hate you, but a day will come when love somewhere will crop up in their heart. So we should always love our enemies. Do not judge others. We should not judge others. That whether, let me see, I'll do like that, whether that person is honest or not. No, we cannot. Have faith in God. We should always have belief in God. We should always trust Him that yes, He is near me. Whenever you do something good, God is always with you. Give to the needy. Now, we should always help the poor and needy person, the one who needs really. So, do unto others as you would have others to do unto you. Children, always do the same which you want to get the same. In the sense, if you do good to others, children, always remember good will come back to you. So, we should always be good with others so that goodness returns back. Here we come to the end of the Sermon on the Mount. Now we'll have a little bit more details of Jesus Christ. There was a small group of disciples. They believed that Jesus was the Messiah who would bring an end to Roman rule. He was only the one sent by God to save them from Roman rule. Now in the second point we see the growing influence of Jesus alarmed Jewish priests. Jesus actually had great followers. He earned lots of followers. And just because of that, these Jewish priests, they were feeling that it was quite threatening for them. Because Jesus was growing, the influence was growing. People were influenced by His teachings and preachings. In the third point we see that after they were little alarmed, they felt threatened by Jesus, and what did they do? They complained to Pontius Pilate. Who was Pontius Pilate? He was the Roman governor. Now what happened? In the fourth point we'll see that he came and he arrested Jesus. Why did he arrest Jesus? He arrested Jesus because they were putting false charge on Him of calling Himself the King of Jews. They were saying that Jesus is calling Himself that I am the King of Jews. But He never did so. But it was a false charge put on Him that He was calling Himself King of Jews. And just because of that, it encouraged the people to rebel against the Roman Empire. He also encouraged the people to rebel against the Roman Empire. Who? This Pontius Pilate. Okay. And what happened as a result of this? Jesus was sentenced to death. This was the only cause or result why Jesus was sentenced to death. Because he was Jewish priests were actually alarmed and they felt threatened by Jesus. They complained Pontius Pilate, and he came arresting him, that putting a false charge on him that he used to call himself the King of Jews. Okay, children, now this slide we come to an end, and let us see in the next slide. In this slide, that is the last slide, we'll learn, that is the end of the chapter, crucifixion. What's the meaning of crucifixion, children? Crucifixion means to put to death by nailing or binding the hands and feet to a cross, as we see here in this picture given at the bottom right hand side corner. In number 1 we see, in 30 CE, Jesus was crucified where? In Golgotha. Remember children, this name you have to remember. And when? In 30 CE. Who was crucified? Jesus was crucified. Where he was crucified? In Golgotha. As a political rebel. This is the reason why Jesus Christ, that cross became a sacred symbol for the Christians, because Jesus was crucified in a cross. So that cross became a sacred symbol for the Christians. And in number third point, we see it gave an end to the hopes of his followers. Just because of this, when he was sentenced to death, at that time what happened? It gave an end to the hopes of his followers, because his crucifixion was viewed by the followers of Jesus Christ and as the end of their hopes. It was just as the end of their hopes when they saw Jesus Christ hanging on the cross. But whereas we see that subsequently many believed that Jesus rose from the dead, they actually saw that Jesus rising from dead and ascending into heaven. So he rose into heaven. After that, what happened? The followers then began to preach in the name of Jesus Christ. Actually, just after this incident, they again restored their courage. They again had their courage back, and the followers began preaching in the name of Jesus Christ. And who were his disciples? They were Saint Peter, Saint John, and Saint Paul. So these disciples, children, you need to learn by heart. Who were the disciples of Jesus? Saint Peter, Saint John, and Saint Paul. It is quite important question might come from here. So in number seventh point, we see Christianity gained acceptance in Rome. And slowly and steadily, we see that Christianity had space in Rome. That is, it gained acceptance. It was accepted in Rome. And in eighth point, we see Bishop of St. Peter. We see that St. Peter Church, they came to be regarded as the Jesus Christ representative. Means, Jesus Christ representatives were also regarded as, or also called as, Pope or Father. So these are the representatives of Jesus Christ, and they were also called by the name Pope or Father. So here, children, we come to an end of the lesson. That is lesson 1. The name of the lesson is Rise of Christianity. Dear students, before starting with the slide, I would just like to discuss the answers to the work assigned to you in my previous class. So the first question is, which century marked the end of the medieval period in Europe? So the answer will be 16th century marked the end of the medieval period in Europe. So second question is, which place did the Roman conquer in the 1st century BC? So the answer to which is, Palestine was the place which the Roman conquered in the 1st century BCE. Question 3, from where do we get to know about the life of Jesus? So the answer to which is, we get to know about the life of Jesus from 4 short books called the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Now we come to the true and false. So the first question is, Jews loved the Roman practice of worshipping the emperors. So the answer will be false. And the second question is, Herod was popular among the Jews. Answer will be false. So I hope you all have corrected it. So now let's come to the slide. Come to learn this. Check the correct answers. The first will be the 5th century marked the end of the medieval period in Europe is 16th century. Second is the Romans conquered this place in the 1st century BC, that is Palestine. Third is we get to know about the life of Jesus from 4 short books called the Gospels. This is the most famous sermon delivered by Jesus Christ, that is Sermon on the Mount. Fifth is Jesus was crucified in. Answer will be Golgotha. Right, true or false, Jews were happy to worship the Roman emperors as God? False. Jesus spread his message through his 12 apostles? True. Jesus asked people to have faith in God? True. Herod crucified Jesus. False. Match the columns. Herod first will be tortured the Jews. Second will be message of Jesus Christ. Third will be Mary and Joseph, parents of Jesus Christ. And this one, Saint Peter, a disciple of Jesus Christ. Give reasons for the following. Romans were unpopular among Jews. Why? Because the ruler Herod used to torture and kill Jews. The second give reason for the following is Jesus Christ earned many followers. Why? Because he had a simple lifestyle and love and compassion for the people. That actually led Jesus Christ many followers. Here we complete with your page number 7 from a history book. Now we'll start with page number 8 in the next slide. In this slide, children, we come to the question answers part, where you can see the first question: what do you understand by the term medieval? The medieval period did not start at the same time all over the world. You have to explain. So I have already explained you this part, children, so you can easily write down. See in page number 4, the very first paragraph. From there you will get the answer, so you can write down. And here, second number, discuss the background against which Jesus Christ emerged as the preacher of the masses. You can see in page number 4 and 5. As because Romans conquered Palestine and Herod became the ruler, he tortured many Jews and killed them. This practice actually infuriated the Jews further, worshipping the emperors. Thus they looked forward for the Messiah who would liberate them. This was only the background which against which Jesus Christ emerged as a preacher of the masses. What do the Gospels tell us about Jesus Christ's life? Children, you can see in page number 5. They actually tell us that Jesus grew up in Nazareth and he followed his father's profession and became a carpenter. But very soon he abandoned it and he began preaching message of love. What did Jesus Christ preach? In question number 4 we can see. It's given in the same paragraph, page number 5. Jesus preached his message in the forms of parables and sermons. From his many followers, Jesus chose 12 apostles to help him spread the message of love and brotherhood. Fifth question, why was Jesus crucified? You can see in page number 6, children. And from this, the down part, from the Sermon on the Mount, after that down part is given over here. The growing influence of Jesus actually alarmed many Jewish priests. And what they felt? They felt threatened by Jesus and they complained to Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor, who arrested Jesus on false charge of calling himself the King of Jews. This was the reason why Jesus was sentenced to death. That is, he was crucified. In the picture study, children, you can see in an artistic impression over here of crucifixion. So who ordered the crucifixion? The question can come. You have to write the Roman governor Pontius Pilate. And second question is, why did Christianity not fade away with the crucifixion of Jesus? It's given in page number 6. That last part, that many people believe that Jesus rose from the dead and ascended into heaven. With this courage, that is the courage which restored this, the followers began preaching in the name of Jesus Christ. And what happened after that? His disciples, the Saint Peter, Saint John, Saint Paul, they all started preaching the message of God. I hope, children, you all must be writing these question answers in your notebooks and keep it ready.